The Voyager spacecraft has always been a source of wonder and excitement, as it sends back incredible images and information from the farthest corners of our universe. But in recent weeks, the data it's been transmitting to Earth has taken a chilling turn. Scientists are now reporting that the information being received is so unnerving, so downright terrifying, that many of them are struggling to come to grips with what it might mean for our future. What has Voyager discovered out there in the vast darkness of space? And what does it mean for us here on Earth? Let's get into the details. The identical Voyager 1 and 2 spacecraft are venturing into uncharted territory, where no spacecraft from Earth has ever flown before. Since their launches in 1977, both of these spacecraft have traveled for more than 40 years, and at this point, they are both significantly further from Earth and the Sun than Pluto. The historical arrival into interstellar space was made by the Voyager 1 spacecraft in August of 2012. Interstellar space is the region between stars and is filled with material that was ejected when surrounding stars died millions of years ago. On November 5, 2018, Voyager 2 entered interstellar space, and scientists hope to get more knowledge about this region as it travels further. Both spacecraft are continuing to communicate with one another over the Deep Space Network, also known as DSN, to relay scientific data regarding their location. The exploration of Jupiter and Saturn was the principal objective of the mission. The duration of the mission was extended when a series of discoveries were made in that region, including the presence of active volcanoes on Jupiter's moon Io and the complexity of Saturn's rings. The only spacecraft ever to have traveled to Uranus and Neptune, Voyager 2 is the only one of its kind to have ever explored those two distant planets. The latest mission of the explorers, known as the Voyager Interstellar Mission, will investigate the farthest reaches of the Sun's sphere of influence and much further. In May, NASA announced that the Voyager 1 space probe had been sending back telemetry data that was either garbled or erroneous. The probe itself appeared to be in fine shape, with a signal that was still powerful enough to beam back information, and nothing appeared to be triggering the probe's fault protection systems, which would put it in safe mode. Since then, the Voyager crew has reportedly not only worked out the problem, but they have also resolved the issue. This information comes from NASA. It turns out that we on Earth are receiving garbled data because the attitude, articulation, and control system of the probe has been transmitting information back through an onboard computer that had stopped functioning years ago. Even before it shut down completely, the computer was damaging the stored data. Voyager project manager Suzanne Dodd stated that when her team had a suspicion that this was the problem, they devised a low-risk remedy. Specifically, they directed the AACS to relay its data through the functional computer of the probe once again. Although the problem has been repaired, the experts have not yet determined why the AACS began sending information to the older computer in the first place. They believed it was caused by an incorrect command issued by one of the other computers on board, which was in turn caused by an underlying problem with the spaceship. NASA has stated that the engineers working on the Voyager spacecraft will continue their search for the root cause of the problem. However, they do not anticipate that it will have a significant impact on the spacecraft's functioning. Trying to get to the bottom of the Voyager 1 problem. It turned out to be a networking problem that was conceptually comparable to those that information technology workers here on Earth might experience. To put it simply, the AACS was successful in its transmission of telemetry data, but it was delivering it to the incorrect computer. Even worse, it was a computer whose hardware had stopped working many years ago. That ended up corrupting the data, which is what caused the communications that were sent to the ground-based team to be all jumbled up and odd. It took some time for the team to find out the issue, and it remained unclear why AACS would have all of a sudden started sending data to the incorrect computer. There is a good chance that it obtained an incorrect command from another machine. This suggests that there is a problem somewhere else that they will need to address and fix. However, as of right now, the problems do not pose a risk to the spaceship. According to Suzanne Dodd, the current project manager for Voyager, after the engineers realized that the obsolete computer could have been a contributing factor to the issue, they were able to find a solution that allowed them to move on. They merely issued a command to the AACS, instructing it to redirect transmitting to the appropriate computer system. Dodd expressed happiness that the telemetry had been restored. "We're happy to have it back. We are going to perform a complete memory readout of the AACS and investigate everything that it has been up to. That will be of great assistance to us as we attempt to diagnose the issue that led to the telemetry issue in the first place. Therefore, we are optimistic with a grain of salt, but there is still more research that needs to be done." The continuous problem with the AACS did not trigger any of the fault protection devices that were on board the spaceship. If it had, the Voyager 1 spacecraft would have entered what's known as safe mode, so that engineers could determine out what went wrong. During the time that the signals were distorted, AACS continued to function normally, which suggested that the issue was located either upstream or downstream of the unit. The fact that the data were jumbled together served as a useful indicator of other computer-related difficulties. Investigations into the solar system. Since its launch in 1977, this spacecraft, despite its advanced age, has been accompanying its identical twin, Voyager 2, on its journeys to the solar system's outskirts to gather scientific data. They each took paths that were somewhat dissimilar to one another. Voyager 2 proceeded on to Uranus and Neptune, while the other two spacecraft stopped after passing Jupiter and Saturn. Both of them are currently well beyond the solar system and are communicating information on the regions of space they are investigating. Jupiter was passed by Voyager 1 in March 1979, and Saturn was passed in November 1980. After making such near encounters with the two gas giants, it started on a trajectory that would take it out of the solar system and into interstellar space in 2013. When this occurred, the instrument was no longer able to detect the solar wind, and at the same time, scientists began to observe an increase in particles that were consistent with those found in interstellar space. At this time, Voyager 1 is well over 61,000 kilometers away from Earth and traveling at a speed of more than 157.3 astronomical units away from our planet. It is hard at work gathering information on the interstellar medium and radiation from objects in the far distance. The spacecraft should be able to continue transmitting data for about 10 years, if everything goes according to plan and if it does not collide with anything that could damage it. After that, there shouldn't be any more noise as it continues on its journey past the Oort cloud and toward the stars. The proof test model of the Voyager space probes was displayed in a space simulator chamber at JPL in 1976. This chamber was a copy of the twin Voyager space probes that were launched in 1977. The scan platform of the model extends to the right, where it holds a number of the spacecraft's science instruments in their extended configurations. The idea is to keep the scientific instruments on board Voyager 2 turned on for a few years longer than was originally predicted, which will allow for even more discoveries to be made in interstellar space. The Voyager 2 spacecraft was launched in 1977 and is currently more than 12 billion miles from Earth. It is equipped with five scientific instruments that are used to reach interstellar space. The aged spacecraft has started utilizing a small pool of backup power that was set aside as part of an onboard safety mechanism to assist in maintaining the functionality of those instruments despite a power source that is running low. As a result of this decision, the mission will be able to delay turning off a scientific instrument until 2026, rather than doing so this year. The spacecraft Voyager 2 and its identical twin Voyager 1 are the only ones that have ever been able to function outside of the heliosphere, which is a protective bubble of particles and magnetic fields generated by the Sun. The probes are providing information that is assisting scientists in answering issues regarding the structure of the heliosphere and the role it plays in shielding Earth from the energetic particles and other forms of radiation that are present in the interstellar environment. The science data that the Voyagers are returning gets more valuable the farther away from the Sun they go, said Linda Spilker, the Voyager's project scientist at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Southern California, which manages the mission for NASA. "Therefore, we are interested in keeping as many science instruments operating for as long as possible," Spilker said. The mission is managed for NASA by the Jet Propulsion Laboratory. This particular radioisotope thermoelectric generator is one of the three radioisotope thermoelectric generators that are installed on each of NASA's Voyager probes. RTGs are responsible for supplying the spaceship with power. This is accomplished by converting the heat produced by the decay of plutonium-238 into electricity. Both of the Voyager spacecraft are powered by RTGs. These generators transform the heat produced by decaying plutonium into electricity. Because of the ongoing process of decay, the generator's output of electricity is gradually decreasing year after year. This far, the decreasing power supply has not affected the amount of scientific data collected by the mission. However, to make up for the loss, the engineers have shut off heaters and other systems that are not necessary to the spacecraft's continued flight. After completing those tasks on Voyager 2, the crew moved on to the next item on their list, which was to select one of the spacecraft's five scientific instruments. Since one of its science instruments failed early on in the voyage, Voyager 1 is functioning with one fewer science instrument than its twin. Because of this, the choice on whether or not to disable an instrument aboard Voyager 1 won't be made until sometime during the next year. The crew looked more closely at a safety mechanism that was designed to protect the instruments if the voltage, the flow of electricity, changed considerably inside the spaceship. Their goal was to find a way to keep one of the science instruments aboard Voyager 2 from having to be turned off. A change in voltage has the potential to cause harm to the instruments, so the Voyager is fitted with a voltage regulator that, in the case of such a fluctuation, will activate a backup circuit. The RTG has been configured to provide the circuit with access to a certain amount of power that has been reserved specifically for this use. This power will no longer be held in reserve for the mission. Rather, it will be used to ensure that the scientific instruments continue to function normally. Even after more than 45 years in flight, the electrical systems on both probes continue to stay rather stable, reducing the necessity for a safety net. This is despite the fact that as a result, the voltage of the spacecraft will not be strictly regulated. Additionally, the engineering staff is able to monitor the voltage and take corrective action if it begins to fluctuate excessively. If the crew discovers that the new strategy is successful for Voyager 2, they may decide to apply it to Voyager 1 as well. According to Suzanne Dodd, Voyager's project manager at JPL, "Variable voltages pose a risk to the instruments, but we've determined that it's a small risk, and the alternative offers a big reward of being able to keep the science instruments turned on for longer. We have been keeping an eye on the spacecraft for the past few weeks, and it appears that this revised strategy is producing the desired results." The Voyager mission was only supposed to endure for a total of 4 years, during which time both probes were supposed to fly by Saturn and Jupiter. Voyager 2 is the only spacecraft ever to have come into contact with the ice giants Neptune and Uranus. This was made possible by NASA's decision to extend the mission so that it could visit both planets. In 1990, NASA decided to extend the mission once more, this time with the intention of sending the probes beyond the heliosphere. Voyager 1 was the first to cross the boundary in 2012, but its twin Voyager 2 crossed it in 2018, despite the fact that it was traveling at a slower speed and in the opposite direction. That's all for the video today. We will be right back with more such amazing videos. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel.